بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. This is the part 2 for the female genital system data show for histology. In this part we will describe the histology of the fallopian tube, uterus, vagina, placenta and mammary gland. This is the picture for the fallopian tube. You can diagnose the fallopian tube by being a hollow organ and the mucosa is highly folded. This is the mucosa formed of epithelium resting on connective tissue, and then we have the muscle tissue, and finally we have the covering serosa. On the right side you can see this is the mucosa. All of this is the mucosa. It is characterized by being very folded, very folded. And after that we will have the musculosa formed of inner circular and outer longitudinal, and on the surface we will have the serosa, very thin connective tissue. And on the left side we have a magnification for the epithelium to notice the epithelial lining of the fallopian tube, which is simple columnar partially ciliated cells. Some of the cells are ciliated, other cells are secretory, and they are named PEG cells. The secretory cells secrete the mucus, while the ciliated cells have a cilia that beats toward the uterus to push the ovum. Under the epithelium, we have the connective tissue, here loose connective tissue, which is the lamina propria. Under the epithelium, we have this connective tissue of lamina propria. After that, you will notice the muscle, as we have said in the previous section. This is another section for the whole fallopian tube, showing the different layers. Here is the highly folded mucosa, epithelium and connective tissue resting on the musculosa, inner circular and outer longitudinal. Take care that the peristaltic movement of this muscle is more important than the cilia in pushing the ovum towards the uterus. Then we have the serosal covering, which is a loose connective tissue covered by simple squamous epithelium, as it is a peritoneal covering. After that, we will move to the other section, which is the section of the uterus. The uterus is a hollow organ. The lumen is flattened. Lumen here is flattened, not a rounded lumen. It is a flattened lumen anteroposteriorly. And the wall is formed of this layer, or this layer is the endometrium. And this layer, which is relatively dark stained, it is the myometrium. And the outermost layer is called the perimetrium. Type. We'll start by the endometrium. It is formed of epithelium and connective tissue corium. This connective tissue corium contains the simple tubular glands of the uterus. And then the muscle layer, it is actually very well developed, but it is poorly differentiated into different layers. Yani you cannot diagnose the different composing layers of this muscle very easily under the microscope. The perimetrium is nothing but the serosal covering. Now move to the other section, which is more magnified for the uterus. This is the hollow organ, flattened lumen. This is the epithelium here, which is formed of simple columnar, partially ciliated, partially secretory. And the secretory cells will form these tubular glands, which are simple tubular uterine glands passing in the connective tissue corium of the mucosa, which is called endometrium. So the endometrium is formed of simple columnar partially ciliated epithelium, secretory and ciliated, resting on a basemembrane with the underlying connective tissue called lamina propria, and sometimes it is called also stroma. يبقى هنا اللامينا propria لها اسم تاني stroma, والepithelium هنا هو أو المنطقة دي كلها بدل الميوكوزا بنقول عليها endometrium. يبقى all this layer is called the endometrium. This is the epithelial lining and this is the connective tissue لامينا فورم او كولد ستروما او اللي هي equivalent to the lamina propria. طيب بعد كده we will have this muscle layer which is very strong, and actually the muscle layer is characterized by having blood vessels inside, very characteristic feature for the muscle of the uterus. So number two, it is the myometrium. Number one, it is the endometrium. Number three, they are the endometrial glands, which are simple tubular glands passing through the stroma or the lamina propria of endometrium. And here we have number four, which are the blood vessels. This one, this one, this one, this one. Now we will have two stages in the endometrium, the proliferative or the follicular phase of endometrium in this picture, and after that we will have the secretory phase. You have to differentiate between the proliferative or follicles and the secretory phase. How to differentiate between the two phases? By looking for two important things. We will look for the endometrial glands. Here the endometrial glands are very narrow lumen. They are straight. They are straight and they have a narrow lumen. This is the endometrial gland in the proliferative stage. Here they are straight, here and there. They are straight, مستقيمة, with narrow lumen. And no secretion, of course, is present inside them, so they are very narrow. This is a very characteristic feature for the proliferative stage. You can see some blood vessels, but these vessels are not congested. يعني هنا appearance of these vessels مش معناه ان دخلت في السكريتوري. لا, انا ههتم اكتر بالإندوميتريال gland. I will make a stress on the endometrial glands which are straight with narrow lumen. If I see some blood vessels, this does not mean it is in the secretory. No, I will depend on the appearance of the glands. Actually, we have blood vessels in the proliferative, but they are not congested and dilated as we will see in the secretory phase. Now move to this phase, very evident secretory or luteal phase of endometrium. You can see how the endometrial glands are dilated and they are having a tortuous appearance, a very highly tortuous appearance, either in this part or in this part. And both in the tortuous appearance, and actually they are very dilated with tortuous appearance. Sometimes you can see the marked congestion of the blood vessels in the endometrium. If it is not present, not important, we will make a stress on mainly on the appearance of the endometrial gland to diagnose the secretory or luteal phase of endometrium. After the endometrium, of course, we will have the myometrium in the wall of the uterus. But now look at this picture. What I can see, I have dilated, very tortuous glands. So this is a secretory or luteal phase. This is the main feature I will use in the diagnosis of the secretory or the proliferative phase. Now let's move to the other organ, vagina. It is a hollow organ. The lumen also is not rounded like that of esophagus, for example. It is collapsed like the lumen of the uterus. The lining here is stratified squamous, non-keratinized stratified squamous epithelium, like the lining of the esophagus. But here we have, under the epithelium, we have as ordinary, we have under the epithelium, the connective tissue or the lamina propria. In this lamina propria, you will notice the presence of a rich high number of blood vessels because it is an erectile tissue. We don't have glands. We don't have muscularis mucosa. After the finishing of the mucosa, we will notice the relatively dark red area of the musculosa, formed of inner circular and outer longitudinal. On the outermost surface, we will have the outer covering of the adventitia. So in this picture, The adventitia is not evident, so in this picture we have here only the mucosa starting from the surface of the epithelium till the start of the muscle. The epithelium here is non-keratinized stratified squamous epithelium, and this relatively dark stained red area compared to the connective tissue corium or lamina propria of mucosa, this area is the musculose. يبقى المسكولوزا هتاخد لون red أغمق من ال connective tissue proper of the lamina propria of mucosa of vagina. In this picture we have a very evident non-keratinized stratified squamous epithelium resting in on connective tissue corium or lamina propria. I don't have glands in the lamina propria. I may see the blood vessels here, as we have said, in all the layers, as it is an erectile tissue. I have blood vessels here in the mucosa, here in the musculosa, here in the adventitia. So in this picture, this one is the mucosa, formed of two elements only. And number two, it is a non-keratinized stratified squamous epithelium. Number three, it is the musculosa, which is also rich in blood vessels. Number four, here we have the outer covering of connective tissue, which is also highly vascular. It is the adventitia. Let's move to the placenta. Placenta, we will have the chorionic villi and the intervellous space. The placenta, you have to differentiate between the early placenta and the late placenta. In the early placenta, what is the difference from the late? In the early placenta, we will have two layers covering the chorionic villus. The outermost layer, it is a syncytium, so it is called syncytio trophoplast, مدمج خلوي. We don't have partitions between the cells. We don't have cell boundaries. The nuclei are evident, but no cell boundaries. This is the syncytio trophoplast. Under the syncytio trophoplast, we have this layer, which is formed of well-defined cells, which is called cytotrophoplast. I can see the boundaries of the cells. So the cyto is the deeper layer in the trophoplast. This is the early. In the early, you will see the cytotrophoplast in addition to the syncytio trophoplast. But in the late, the cyto will disappear. After that, we will have this connective tissue of the chorionic villus. And inside the connective tissue, you will notice this fetal blood capillary, very evident, lined by flat squamous cells containing RBCs. In between the villi, we will see the maternal blood. Here, it is the maternal blood. This is an early because I can see the cytotrophoplast in addition to the syncytium. But in the late, this is also early, as I have. This is the syncytio trophoplast, and this is the cytotrophoplast. The cytotrophoplast is formed of these well-defined cells present under the syncytio trophoplast. Then we have this connective tissue of the chorionic villus, and it shows also the fetal blood vessels lined by flat squamous cells and contain the RBCs. After that, we have in between these chorionic villi, the maternal blood can be easily seen in between these chorionic villi. Here it is also a late placenta. Why? Because I can see only the, this is early, and this is the late placenta. Why it is late? Because I can see only the syncytio trophoplast. I cannot see at all the cytotrophoplast. Here, one layer for the trophoplast, and this is the connective tissue of the chorionic villus containing the fetal blood capillaries, and in between here, we have the maternal blood. So, number one, here, it is the fetal blood vessel or fetal blood capillary. Number two, it is the syncytio trophoplast. Number three, it is the chorionic villus as a whole. Number four, it is the intervillous space containing maternal blood. Sometimes you can see some collection of nuclei to form this knob present in the syncytio trophoplast. This will increase with the advancement of the pregnancy. يعني ده بيدل على ان بتبتدي البلاسينتا تبقى of higher or older age. يبقى إذن with the increase of the gestational age بيبتدي يبان عندنا السنسيتيال نوب. ادي واحدة بس اللي باينة هنا, هي عبارة عن cluster of nuclei of the syncytiotrophoblast. طيب هنا هنبص نلاقي الصورة اللي بعد كده, دي بقى very very evident syncytial knots. syncytial knots ديا بتقولنا زي ما اتفقنا ان هي عبارة عن aggregation of the nuclei of syncytiotrophoblast that will appear with the increase in the gestational age. After that we have this is maternal blood. These are the fetal blood capillaries. يبقى هنا وده كده الكوريونيك فيلس as a whole. نيجي بعد كده هندخل على الماماري جلاند. هنجد عندنا في two sections, resting mammary gland and the lactating mammary gland. هنا الريستنج ماماري جلاند it shows only few lobules with very thick connective tissue septa, هو المين بارت, واللوبيولز عندي very minimal and they contain only the ducts, the lactiferous ducts. These are the ducts here with no acini or with no gland secreting milk. After this picture also I can see that the viperous connective tissue is very thick, taking most of the picture with very few ducts as you see. These are the ducts. What are the ducts lined with? The ducts are lined with simple cuboidal epithelium and surrounded by myoepithelial cells. You may be asked in the question of the exam about the lining of these ducts. This picture for the lactating mammary gland, you can diagnose the marked reduction of the connective tissue stroma and the large number of the secretory acini. The acini are full of secretion of milk, which will be acidophilic and vacuolated due to the dissolvement of the fat present in this secretion. The lining epithelium of the acinus is always depending upon the activity. But it is usually simple columnar cells surrounded by myoepithelial cells. Don't forget the appearance of the milk, which is vacuolated acidophilic. This is the picture for the lactating mammary gland. You can see here the marked reduction in the thickness of the septa. You can see this connective tissue septum here, markedly reduced if you compare it with the resting mammary gland. Now, before we go to the trial, we have another slide for the lactating mammary gland. You can notice that the connective tissue septa are markedly reduced. The lobules are full of acini, as you see. And these acini are full of milk, as you see, which is acidophilic and vacuolated. Now, this is a relatively large lactiferous duct present in the connective tissue septum between the different lobes or lobules of the breast, and this is the duct. So the duct will be in the connective tissue septum and it is mostly wider than the acinus. Both of them can show the milk secretion, which is acidophilic vacuolated to dissolvement due to dissolvement of the fat in this secretion. I think this is the last slide in the presentation. Don't forget to look for the trial test of the female and another video for the theoretical description of these slides. Thank you very much.